Kyrgios came out firing against the reigning Open champ.
These are the matches you want to be involved in, playing the best player in the world in probably the best stadium in the world.
There was his customary sass mouth.
I've never had a problem with this tournament apart from you.
Several racket smashes.
Now he's frustrated.
And a tirade directed towards his box. He won the first set in a tiebreak.
That's why, epic opening set.
Sure, Medvedev won the second set. But the third was all Kyrgios. He hit winners.
Nice.
He also fell awkwardly, and Medvedev started walking over like he was going to end him, Mortal Kombat style.
Finish him.
Turned out he was just being nice.
Yeah.
Anyway, then Nick tried to win a point by crossing onto the other side of the net.
I'm not sure that that's allowed.
Yeah, nah, it's not.
Foul shot. You cannot cross the net. The ball's not dead yet.
But despite the blunder, the Aussie went on to dominate his opponent, winning in four sets.
And he dethrones the champion and is through to the quarterfinals.
I still can't believe the boneheaded play I made over here. I thought that was legal, to be honest, but that's going to be everywhere on SportsCenter, so I'm going to look like an idiot. So that's us, all right.
I feel like that shot sums up everything about Nick Kyrgios. Like, on the one hand, brilliant, very entertaining. On the other hand,
why?
What are you
doing? Yeah, it's the kind of thing you might do in, you know, with your mate in the park.
Yes.
Isn't he perfect in New York, though? They would love him.
I reckon he's embracing. I think he loves the idea of America and New York more so than even London, even Australia, the French
Open. When that grabby play there, I thought it was really interesting that Todd Woodbridge was commentating. Yeah. Todd Woodbridge is a complete opposite to what Nick Kyrgios is. Yeah. Mm. And Todd will be just shaking his head.
He's playing phenomenal tennis, though. 21 aces, 53 winners, the tennis of his life. Todd Woodbridge said that in commentary as well. Final of Wimbledon, and he is the favourite. There's no hiding that he's the favourite to take out the US Open. But this is fantastic. I know we love him, then we don't love him as much, but he takes us on a journey. This is what
Nick Kyrgios does. Where are we on the love him, don't love him meter currently?
Loving him.
Loving him.
Yeah. I've never really hated him.
Loving?
Yeah.
I think he's doing really well. Ila Tomljanovic is doing incredibly well too, into the quarterfinal of back-to-back Grand Slams. And it was the question around this, I guess, is after defeating Serena Williams, would she be able to go again and back up? But this was a straight sets win. She had to dig really, really deep after that exhausting win, really, against Serena. But she's done a fantastic job, and it's great to see two Aussies go so far.
How long would we have to go back, or has it ever happened, that we've won the men's and women's US Open?
Oh, I don't think it has ever happened. Can you think of a...
No. I can't. You've thrown that question at me
Bruce?
Without the facts.
I'll get back to you. I'll Google it.
Thank you.